supervise this city council from the one-party dictatorship that has become. In a democracy, there's only here a North Korea where the senior representative cannot be held up to question by anyone else within the system. That must change. We can start that change today, and we can change it again when the Constitution and Judiciary Committee meets to consider the recommendations from our
colleagues. Mr. Anderson, do you want to respond?
I'll respond to a couple of things, Laurie, because I don't really know what he was asking. I don't think he did. The fact... It's amazing, isn't it? Yes, of course, you're absolutely right about the housing estates and the Labour administration wanting to look at selling the housing stock. You're absolutely right, I remember that. So that doesn't make it any less, impalatable. Because you drove that through, your administration drove that through, and it was lack of investment by all administrations in the housing stock that failed the people of this city. And I accept that. Made criticisms of it. So for you to pontificate about that, the man who was sent out of the city by his own party because of the Boot Estate fiasco, and your conduct with somebody else that was doing public grants and taking grants and funding. I remember only too well what Mr. Nim and yourself in terms of working for him and doing consultancies. So don't you lecture me about the openness and the transparency of this administration. You've got something to say on that, then let me hear from your solicitor. With regards to the comments that he's making around openness and transparency, this is a man that has never turned up to any cabinet meeting where we've discussed any of the issues on housing, where we've had a report about the housing company that's been presented, we've had a report to the housing committee that's gone to the Regeneration Select Committee, and he's never turned up. And then he tries to reinvent the Mayoral Select Committee. I can tell you that out of 300 questions that were raised at the Mayoral Select Committee, 299 of them were about the bus lanes from the Greens. The bus lanes have long since gone. So it was a waste of my time and a waste of everybody's time because people were scrutinising the Mayor who were playing politics. And it really is that simple. I've got better things to do. We've got a city to run. We've got 1 in 4 children in poverty. We've got a housing shortage and a housing problem. We've got universal credit forcing people out on the streets. The food bank's numbers of usage is going up and up every single week. And we've got serious problems to deal with and attend to. And that's what we intend doing. Not allowing Mr. Kemp or his colleagues to grandstand at select committees or whatever. Turn up to the cabinet meetings. Turn up to the cabinet committee meetings of every fortnight. Turn up to the select committees and let's hear what you've got to say. You're talking about openness and transparency in the way select committees turn up. You're at the meeting in March when we discussed it and my response to what I've just made today. But you weren't there. And then he talks about the council officers and council members going on trips. Every one of the trips made by either me or any councillor is about delivery. It's about making contact and bringing back important contacts and relationships with our city abroad, whether it's the Shanghai, £50-odd million invested in Henry Bach, that was made as a result of our relationship with Shanghai. Many, many other businesses being supported. Our Surabaya trip with 11 businesses coming back and talking about investments. Have you read the recent report from City Liverpool Vision about the jobs that have been created, about the investment being made as a result of what we've been doing? This isn't taking a quarter of £1 million taxpayers' money through the LGA or the UCLG flying across the world to pontificate and put yourself out there. This is about doing real things that benefit this city, and we won't stop because you want to smear or want to put people down, because it's the right thing to do, because we are a glorious city and we are a great city.
Standing Order 2112, as a series of scurrilous attacks have been made on me by the Mayor, I request the right to make a personal explanation in response to them at the end, after this vote is held.
Okay, thank you for that. Ms. Wallace.
Thank you, my Lord Mayor. I wish to speak on Amendment 3, Regeneration and Sustainability. We've just heard the Lord Mayor there attack Councillor Kemp on describing... Lord Mayor. I meant the elected Mayor. The Mayor described Councillor Kemp's visits, of how elaborate they are. But, we would like to stop that, because the way you describe Councillor Kemp could be the way the general public think about the visits that are being taken by delegations going overseas. Now, we recognise that it's very important and it's very significant that this city carries out overseas delegations, and we understand, we recognise that the importance that we need to establish links and promote the city worldwide to other investors. But as we believe that in the interest of clarity and transparency, that these trips abroad will need to be reported back and clarified how the aims and objectives are received. So therefore, what we'd like to happen is to add a bullet point in the second paragraph, which states, receiving from the Mayor a report on each overseas visit made by him, other elected members and officers, undertaken with a view with increasing investment in the city. Now, that is quite clear. If you don't want criticism from outside the way you've described Councillor Kemp, I think it's in the best interest that this is included in item 12.
Lord Mayor, I wasn't going to speak tonight. But just as a point of clarity, the visits that take place on this side of the House, and by me in particular, have been very actively reported at employment and skills, which some of our opposition members have attended, read and asked questions on. And it is done every single time, whether that is to Indonesia or to China. Every visit has been reported, and has been reported at select committees. So perhaps our members need to read the papers that they actually questioned at those committees.
Councillor Radcliffe.
I think there's a danger. Sometimes we talk about the people and not talk about the motion. And I think the debate's gone that way. Can I just ask members to, before we vote, to focus on what is being actually tabled? The Lib Dem amendment is suggesting the mayoral visits, mostly visits, go to the Regeneration Committee. However, if they've been listening to the debate, the Mayor has already announced they will go to Ordnance and Governance. So the amendment is purely about which report goes where, rather than those reports being made. I think it's important we do consider that. So that has been on the table. We've already received information on the details of the Housing Committee will be done when a bit more research is done. I think we should accept that in good faith. I would also make the comment, our former council colleague, Councillor Anne Hines, chaired the panel that looked after the transfer of stock to LMH, and there was an incredibly lot of positive work done, I have to say, as a community centre, but I read Ms. Councillor Rennie ran. There was a whole year's work of intense work by residents groups that made that so successful. And I think the city benefited from that. And I think sometimes when we try to look for differences of who didn't do what, we've got to say, well, who did a lot of work and move the ball game on. And then lastly, we've got the first part of the amendment is about reviewing core groups. Well, we have got a peer review taking place. So I have to say, I think on behalf of the Liberal Party group, we see no distinctly added value to it. But can I say something that actually made my stomach turn earlier? Many of you may remember in a previous debate, I actually said I worked for as a volunteer with a group called Underground Evangelical. We actually helped Christians take Bibles into the far Soviet Union, and we helped take people out. To have this council compared to North Korea, where people are being systematically starved because of their religious or political convictions, I found really distasteful. And I would ask the member to retract that comment. Because whilst I may not always agree with everything the mayor does, and sometimes I've had some parliament exchanges that I felt were inappropriate on both parties, and we'll take that with protest. I think to make that comparison is actually stomach churning. If people knew what political persecution and torture on a systematic scale is taking place in North Korea, I fear you find that distasteful. And having it for someone who's actually worked to help religious refugees, I feel it very personally.
Thank you for that, Councillor. I'm going to go to the Layford response and then we're going to go to the vote. Ned Anderson.
Councillor, thank you for the point. It's part of this perception, isn't it, that they try to create themselves, that, you know, it's really best of Jones having an attack on them when they throw things and do things like that, but it's like more difficult. But they put that same rubbish out in the streets, you know, on leaflets and get away with it. You know, so the bottom line is the Surabaya trip. We've just signed a twinning relationship with Surabaya. Now the reason why we did that is because they're bringing a large delegation to the IFB, and that's going to benefit the city, and there are also companies that are interested in investing here. So that delegation that's coming to the city from Surabaya for IFB follows on from other delegations from our relationships with Birmingham, Alabama, who are coming back. Many of the delegations, Chinese delegations and people that we've visited, and I don't think there's any councillor in this council who works as hard as Gary Miller to promote our city and bring in investment into our city, and yet he's smeared constantly, helped and aided and abetted by the Liberal Democrats. I went to Surabaya. I was up at 3:45 in the morning, and 28 hours later, after three flights, one of them with chickens and goats, I arrived in Surabaya. I spent 48 hours there and then flew back again the same way, 28 hours. I'm a granddad. I love my grandkids and I love my wife, and I love every opportunity I had to spend with them. And yet they call it a jolly. I remember jollies being taken by that administration. My Christ, I remember them and will never forget them. What we do and what we do as an administration is because it's in the interests of this city. And I repeat that. And I remember 2008, and we backed the Shanghai relationship. We supported the Shanghai relationship. And that was in Shanghai, but also going to the World Expo in 2010. And the Liberal Democrats had committed a culture programme, a sporting programme with Shanghai, and when they got kicked out of power, kicked out of office in May, they then tried to say we shouldn't go, and we didn't, and we went, because it was the right thing to do, and that's what we will always do.
And irrespective of what they say, and this nonsense about scrutiny, we get more FOIs about what we do as a council on trips, and we give it to people freely, and if people want to know, because we don't gain from it, we gain nothing from it other than what's in the best interest of this city. That's the way it will be, irrespective of what Councillor Martin Maynard was saying. That's the way it will always be, because it's the right thing to do.
Okay, no, no. Okay. We're going to the vote, right? So, McCarthy.
Against.
Sullivan.
Against.
Sung.
Against. Thomas, Thompson,
against.
Tootle,
against.
Alan Walker,
against.
Sue Walker, Walton,
against.
Walson,
against.
Wood,
against.
Woodhouse, and the Lord Mayor.
Okay. For the motion, 10, against 69, no abstentions, so the motion falls. So, amendment. So we go to the main one. So, all's in favour? Agreed. Okay, thank you for that. Okay. Let's go on to item 13, scheduled dates. No. Looked at the standard orders here, Councillor Kemp, and I'm not having a pantomime to run through there. This is my face right here. So I'm going to say, outside of here, you can make your, videos, but I'm not having it. Oh. I'm stopping it now.
I'll do it through.
Yeah, you do that. Okay. Councillor,
can you sit down?
I am defending everybody and I'm telling everybody, move on, come on. Right, item 13, Councillor Rasmussen.
Can I move that the schedule of dates for 2018-19 and 2019-20 be approved? With regard to the planning committee, the first scheduled date will be designated for formal training of the committee, and the meeting of the 19th of June be set as the first meeting of the committee for the 2018-19. And any subsequent proposed changes to the schedule of dates for 2018-19 to be considered by the whips following consultation with the relevant members.
14, Scrutiny Annual Report, Councillor Rasmussen.
As recommended by the Overview and Scrutiny Chair's briefing, the Scrutiny Annual Report for 2017-18, as set out on pages 194 to 228 of the Council agenda, be approved.
Agreed. Thank you. Appointment of outside bodies, Councillor Mary Rasmussen.
To move the recommendation of the Constitutional Issues Committee held on the 10th of June 2018, that the 2017-18 schedule of appointments to outside bodies and partnerships be extended until July 2018, in order to enable the current appointments to outside bodies continue until the next City Council meeting on the 18th of July, subject to any changes proposed at the meeting. Directors and Cabinet members to review their current list of appointments to outside bodies in the context of how the body helps to achieve the Council's objectives, whether the Council need to be involved in the body at all, and whether the current appointed members have any communications from the organisation within the last 12 months. Officers be requested to ensure that all those members who are appointed be made aware of their legal duties and responsibilities and potential personal liabilities, and a further report be submitted to the next City Council meeting providing information on proposed revisions to appointments to outside bodies, including details of any changes to council representatives. In terms of the list included on the agenda, Councillor Wendy Simon, Deputy Mayor Designate, Councillor James Noakes, Cabinet Member for Streetsy, Transport and Highways, Air Corsi, and Councillor Barbara Murray, Cabinet Member for Education, replaced Councillors Anne O'Brien, Nick Small and Steve Mumby as the relevant Cabinet Members.
Is that agreed? Okay. Item 16, appointment of the Liverpool City Region Combined Authority. Councillor Keir Rasmussen.
I'm running out of voice.
I know.
Can I move Mayor Anderson be appointed as the City Council representative on the Liverpool City Region Combined Authority, with Councillor Wendy Simon as an alternate, and Overview and Scrutiny Committee three Labour members, Councillors Tricia O'Brien, Patrick Haley, Laura Robertson-Collins, Transport Committee, four Labour members, Councillors Anthony Lavelle, Natalie Nicholas, Liam Robinson and Helen Thompson.
Is that agreed?
Agreed.
Appointment to the Mayor's Joint Authority.
Can I move the appointment of members to the following Merseyside Joint Authorities for 2018-19? Merseyside Fire and Rescue Authority, Fire Labour and Mourners Victim, Councillors Peter Brennan, Sharon Connor, Barbara Murray, James Roberts and Sharon Sullivan. Merseyside Recycling and Waste Authority for Labour, Councillors Tony Conception, Joe Hanson and Laura Robertson-Collins. Police and Crime Panel, three Labour. Councillors Alice Bennett, Ruth Bennett and Jeremy Wolfson.
My Lord Mayor, I move the nomination of Councillor Andrew Lakerson to the Fire Authority.
Okay, that agreed?
Agreed.
Right, 18. Appointment to the LGA General Assembly.
Can I move that the following members be appointed to exercise the votes indicated? Mayor Joe Anderson, OBE, three votes. Councillor Wendy Simon, two votes. Councillor Lily Hinnigan, two votes. Councillor Gary Miller, two votes.
That agreed? Item 19, Liverpool City Region Combined Authority Business Rates Supplements Funding. Mayor Anderson, sorry.
Can I move that the Council consent to making the order by the Secretary of State to confer on the Liverpool City Region Combined Authority the powers as set out in the draft order entitled the Liverpool City Region Combined Authority Business Rate Supplements and Functions Order as set out in the supplementary agenda?
That agrees.
I wonder if I could just ask the Mayor a question on that. Within this document, there is an element in which those businesses with a rate of value of more than £50,000 may be liable to this rate. That includes several stores, for example, Debenhams, Marks and Spencer's in the city centre, who also pay a similar supplement through the bid company, which they also do by choice. I was just wondering if there is clarity yet on whether there is any conflict between the two. And whilst I wouldn't want to stop this today, because it has a much wider impact, whether or not we've considered that the effects that this will make or possibly make on the bid.
Mayor Anderson.
Lord Mayor, the acceptance of the statutory powers enabling us to do what it is suggested and what is stated in the report. There is no proposal to do that, and if there is, a debate and a discussion will take place in this chamber, but at the moment there is no plans for any business rates tax, although the power exists in order to do that.
Thank you. Is that agreed? Okay, thank you. That's the end of the meeting. I do thank you for your response to my no phones. One or two years did get the phones out. In the future, I will name and shame you. So let's keep it and let's respect one another. Let's respect one another. Thank you. Thank you.